aluminum on the surface of the part is converted from aluminum to aluminum oxide, more wear resistant and more durable finish. Parts are racked onto tooling and then loaded onto load bars and run through an anodizing line like the one you see behind me. Parts first go through a cleaning bath where oils, debris, and dust are cleaned off the parts. Parts then go into an etch bath where naturally occurring oxides are removed and the surface is prepared uniformly for finish. Parts then go through a deoxidation bath where the residual residue left over from the etch bath is removed, and then parts go into the anodized bath. During the anodized process, columns of oxide are created out of the aluminum. This makes the anodic coating an integral part of the part itself, unlike applied coatings like paints. In the center of this oxide coating is a pore structure. If parts are being used in an architectural application and color is desired, parts are put into another bath containing inorganic metals that are electrolytically placed in the pore structure of the coating. Whether coating is colored or remains clear, all parts are put into a seal bath to complete the process. In the seal bath, coating is hydrated to retain the color and give the coating its resistance to weathering. Upon removal from the seal bath, the process is complete and the parts can be unracked, packed, and sent to the customer. For more information about anodizing or other architectural finishes for aluminum, please contact Linetec at www.linetec.com.